To freestyle, Sun Yat.
He sees that he is starting to pick it up. 150 to go, and it's out to 2.28. So if it's 2.28 and the world record is 14.34, we're at 14.31. Because it's 14.34.
For sure. So he's going to get close, you think, to the 14.30. I mean, Saunakoff was the first to break 15 minutes. Then we've got Perkins under 14.50. And have a look at this battle with Mullooly coming up to Cochrane. And then, of course, it was Hackett who broke the 14.40. Could we possibly see the first 14.30? Mullooly continues to close. 100 metres to go for Sun Yan. 100 metres to go for Cochrane and Mullooly. And a battle for fourth and fifth as well.
Well, Sun Yan now bringing a kick in. Look at this. You're seeing a rolling 6 feet kick. He's really picked his stroke rate up as well. So will we see under 14.30 for the first time in the 1500?
It's a huge ask because he came home in 55.42 when he broke that world record. Well, could he come home in just about the fastest time he's ever come home in his life? And he's got that world record behind him. He's flying away.
He's sprinting. He's absolutely sprinting like a 50 freestyle.
He knows what he's after. It's a gold medal again for China for Sun Yan here in London. Well, the world record is 14.34.14. We haven't had a world record in the 1500 at the Olympics in a long, long time, since 92. It's the fastest of all time. It misses the magical mark by 1.02. Next time for that, Cochrane and Mullooly. What a race for second and third. And Cochrane gets under 14.40 for the first time in his life. So four men now in history are under 14.40, and three of them are side by side at the moment. Coming home for fourth place then is Park Tae-Wan and then Paul Treneri.